things that Mike taught me, I haven't used. I just didn't feel very comfortable, and I just kind of gave up on it. But I did a lot of the stuff he showed me I did, but not all. A couple of things I just didn't feel right.
For example?
Well, the shifting to the right, getting lined up and then leaning to the right, I had a lot of trouble with that.
You mean an address?
Yeah, it lined me up. You know, this was a big problem I had. My feet were pointing straight ahead, yet me open up my left foot. And then after I got set, kind of leaned to the right. And I felt like I was losing my balance a little bit. It didn't feel good, so I just kind of let that go. I changed my grip about a couple of months ago, and it does help me a lot too. I went to interlocking instead of helped me keep my hands together.
Why don't you hit a few with your 5-iron gun?
Okay. Tee it up or off the grass?
Off the mat.
My swing down a lot more than I was hitting the ball too far. I was getting a lot of distance, but I wasn't getting the accuracy, so I tried to, you know, so my back swing, I'm not going back nearly as far as I used to go. You know,
I see.
Overload the arm. So that's helping. You know, you're learning all the time.
noticeable difference there.
I just think you'd get the lower body going first.
Oh, God, I'm trying to.
You did it, though. Sign you up for the senior tour now.
He's got a sense of humor, huh?
That's a putting head trainer.
Oh, really?
Thank you. same thing and really work on getting your lower body initiating your spine. Let's take a look at these.
Yeah, I guess anything over 100 is good.
Yeah.
But before, I was around 118. But it could be, I had a different club too. A little more whip to it. Inside out too, it's a little open. I haven't been looking at that, I was looking more at the speed. Outside in, 2 degrees. Degrees open.
Yeah, that would have been a slice.
Boy, this thing is great. You can just get to read it. I was looking at the speed, forgetting everything else.
That looked good.
Side in 4 degrees.
That's probably your, when you get a good shot on the course. Like you say, your power fade.
Yeah.
So that's a power fade. Got to reset this.
He's a golfer, can only think of one thing at a time. Can't walk and chew gum at the same time. And that's the outside end.
One more thing, John. I want to try something here. I'm on everything else. Lower your hands a little bit.
On the club?
Yeah. More of a relaxed position.
Okay.
It's not a big deal. It's just maybe a half inch or so. There you go. Just try it again. You don't want to stand any closer to the ball. Like your hands.
So like that? Or am I doing it too much?
That's a little bit too much.
It's hard to do. Concentrate on doing that. We get it right now. If I try it real slow, I might be able to do some of these things more. That went up to 113. That's quite a difference.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing how fast you pick this up and you do it right away. Some people I have to repeat and never do.
Well, I do think a lot about this game, and I've read a million magazines, and I'm trying. I think I'm getting closer to knowing what I do wrong, but I'm not positive. And I think you're right. I'm able to correct it, at least for the time being. You can sure get into a problem real quick, though.
Boy, that sounds good. I'm going to make a few notes, John, about what you can think about when you're out practicing,
okay,
what we discussed here.
Can I just hit a few irons?
Sure, it's still recording,
okay.
So go ahead and hit away.
Good. But I want to get as much of the tape as I can.
And think about that shoulder rotation, even with the irons.
Okay.
More of a one unit with your shoulders and your arms. That's it.
A lot more zipping. I know, by keeping the bringing the club back stiffer, not breaking the wrist so quick. play with a group, I play just about every day, but I play with a group on Monday, where there's a...